Hey, don't knock my drinks over with your pocketbook, buddy. Hey, buddy.
She put it on such a display. She got a big, but so tough. Man, oh man, a sense. Do I feel less bitter? You know, Times Square, what happened, you know? That's the title of the book. I went up there the other day. I don't want to tell you what I was looking for, but I had forgotten what happened. And, you know, having a nice conversation with the crack whore, right? And all of a sudden it dawns on me, she's not real. She's a Disney animatronic crack whore. Shocking. Ladies and gentlemen, on the drums, Tony Makima.
But at least they would remain.
up and says here, "Dear Buster, you are one of the most fascinating musicians. Love David." Oh, excuse me. This is my morning affirmation. I don't know how I'm doing with this thing. Oh. I saw this guy walking, you know, this thing is like weird.
Hey, there's a big boom in it.
Yeah. You know, I mean, you think I'm bitter now. Let's see how this evening progresses. Speaking of bitter, I saw this guy walking down the street so bitter, I was like, oh, like, you want to look like Pollyanna? Stand next to this guy, all right? Bitter. Apparently, he had been through the worst divorce of his entire life. I mean, this one was the worst. She took everything, and he was bitter. And, you know, he finds over by the Disney place, apparently Aladdin had dropped this lamp or something, and he finds it in a dumpster, and out pops a Jewish genie. And he says, "Hello, my friend, for you I got 3 wishes, but there's a hang-up." Sure, there's a hang-up. There's always a hang-up. "What's the hang-up?" He says, "Well, everything you wish for, you get, but the X gets double." He says, "I know that. What's your first wish, sir?" He says, "Well, Jesus, I'm walking. She took the car, so, you know, what the hell? You know, give me a Rolls Royce." "One Rolls Royce coming up, the X gets 2. I heard you the first time. "For your second wish, sir?" "I'm going to need some riding around money. So give me $1 million. $1 million coming up, the X gets 2. "Sure. And now for your third and final wish, sir?" He says, "I want you to beat me half to death."
Yeah.
Contest is emotion. You know what a voguing contest is?
Sure.
So the first drag queen comes in and all dressed in red with a beautiful red dress and a red wig. The whole Magilla red. And everyone says, ooh, Miss Scarlet, what emotion are you representing? She says, I am red with rage.
Ooh.
Surely you are red. And then the second drag queen comes in all dressed in green with like this like mermaid kind of green sea. Well, I'll never eat a red drag again. This green sequin. I'm trying to integrate all my personalities, you know. I don't want to just be bitter because really I'm only bitter when I'm up here, so I'm trying to bring in some of my life. And never mind, I'll tell you later. My shrink is like, he really asks too much. Anyway. I just lied to him. Anyway. All dressed in green. With a little netting and like Undine rising from the sea. And everyone says, Miss Chartreuse, what emotion are you representing? She says, I am green with envy. So then the next drag queen comes in, Miss Thing, right? Now Miss Thing is part of like the lesbian act up anarchist collective of the Bogey group. And she's a real pain in the ass. And she's what they call, she's not content. You know what I'm saying? Like, who is? But she's not content. And she comes in, and she's like totally nude, except for a cigarette hanging on her mouth, and a very, like, New York pair of, like, Dewey pumps. And her schlong is in a bowl of pudding. Everybody goes, I'm Miss Thing. At it again. The malcontent is back. What emotion could you possibly be representing? She says, I am fucking disgusted.
I'm still a bit funny, but I'm
As mentioned earlier, it's called Buster's Spanish Rocket Ship. Makes sense.
Yeah.
To me it does. I don't know. Abstract reasoning, you know, it's very, very important to get along in this realm, at least the one I'm in. Oh, perceptions. You think you got it bad. Boom. You should see what I see. Yes. I know, very kind of like psychological thing. I'm going into a cosmic kind of a realm. You know, we taped the RuPaul show last week. I don't know if anybody's ever seen the RuPaul show on VH1. Because we have to do all these things, like, you know, to like let people know that we have a record out. We're backstage, and they give us, like, you know, this room to hang out in, and everybody's doing what people in a band do. You know, I don't know what they do because I don't do it. I have to keep my wits about me, you know. And so they come and they go, you know who our other guest is? And I go, no, who? And they say, Ivana. And I'm like, no. They say, yeah, isn't that great? And I go, like, yeah. That's really great. Like, what does she do? They say, home shopping. I go, like, oh, wow. That's cool. Because everything is cool on that show. Really cool. And I'm, like, really bitter, you know? So I'm wondering, like, it's like a really a self-help show gone riot. That show. I don't know if you've seen it, but everybody's beautiful and everything is wonderful. And I'm like, Miss Thing. So backstage, right, I'm waiting to go on, and Ivana goes on first, right? And I go, Nirvana is wearing like this disco dress, right? And she's like really thin with like these huge bosoms, right? Like a pop stick with bosoms, she looks like. And she's, you know, waiting to go on, and I'm standing, hi, Ivana, how are you? She's going, I just want to go out and sell my home shopping, and then I have to leave. I have very important things to do. And I'm saying, Ivana, stick around, come out, you know, we'll have laughs, you know, it'll be great. And she looks at me like, oh, fuck, okay? So she goes on, and I'm watching the monitor with all these, like, stage hands, and, like, the woman from the record company who took us there. And I'm funny. They're playing like this game, her and Ivana, shaggable or not shaggable. And so like they show this movie star like she goes, Brad Pitt, shaggable or not shaggable. And I'm back there going, I'd like to take that guy, I'd have him waxed, and then we go on a camping trip and I'm killing, you know. I'm killing. The record company lady's going, shh, 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 you know. So you know you're doing good. So I'm like, oh, I'm going to kill. Like, dude, you know, I'm just going to kill. So I'm finally going, now you're the handsome guy. What's your party, Dexter? And I come out, like, all right, let's go, you know. And then I walk up to RuPaul, and I'm like, I'm like in shock. Like, and my subconscious is screaming. Dead air time! And I'm just like, I feel like I'm about like 11 years old, right? And I'm like, hello, lady. Hello, nice lady. I don't know if it's the looking up or to see this like 11-foot drag queen. I felt like a little boy, and I'm all of a sudden, all the stuffing was out of me. She's like, so where are you from? And I'm like, where am I from? Who cares? I mean, and then she says, you and Ivana, you've both been on the social scene in New York for so long. Tell me, do you run into each other out there? So I take Ivana's hand and I go, you ever go to the Blarney Stone on 8th Avenue? I never go to 8th Avenue, darling. I'm sure they'll air this like, you know, 10,000 times. My humiliation. But then we sang, which seems good. But really, how do you find that in the dark? Speaking of thin, we have a song. We have an ode to thin from our new record. Just a Spanish rocket jet. Available in fine stereo. Story having had it come, I stopped at a moment when she kissed me. The clothes were so bonito, es cuando me cambió. Adoro somebody keeping me in there, who was very sweet to me. But when I wear it on the oars, it's much easier to speak. Quienes que llamamos un rato, she said, you can't talk to me. Skinny bones, skinny bones, Monty was what skinny bones. Skinny bones, skinny bones. All she was skin and bone. I just told her to love Harry, wasn't even no exquisite or matinee. But even at who's the guia, she looked flaco as what was a mente. As if it's more than a piece of robots, I am the abriendo. She said, estoy andadita, and I've been for 20 años. I can't remember my, you know. Por favor, take me home. Skin and bones. Skin and bones. All she was skin and bones. Skin and bones. Skin and bones.
Foxy wants what Skinner wants.
John Carpenter film, you know, basically, you have sex, you're gonna die. Okay. Oh.
from Florida, but it's close enough. But he was a, but he played the...
Truth is refreshing, you know? And personally, I don't understand it. Up. He's doing his perp walk. It's the last time I will tell the truth to you. Bastards! Sure. I think we can do a little like Haitian kind of yellow.
yellow bird food.
Like there's poison in my mind, and there ain't no kind of pill that can take that away. I've gotta see that girl. I'm gonna curl up in her arms in her bed and fade away. Gotta get away. Gotta get away. Gotta get away from the devil. Gotta get away from the world. And the closer that I get to heaven, that's the closer I get to that girl. Sometimes it's this mean old world that makes me feel alone. I wanna feel some joy like a little boy. She can't take away this pain I'm feeling today. Gotta get away. Gotta get away from the devil. Gotta get away from the world.
That was good. That was good.
so obsessed with death. Like, and like, why? That whole curse of Mummy's Tomb thing. It's like, and maybe it had something to do with how I spent my youth. I don't know. But I'm not bald at this point. I just want to say to you all that I have thought about death so much that I know exactly how I'm going to die. That's not funny. Tragedy plus time. And I've waited about 4 hours. You can hear a pin drop. I've really stepped over the line. But that's okay. You know, because if I drop dead on this stage, it wouldn't be that bad, because I've done things that kings and queens have never done. Kings anyway. But I'm not big on impressions, but I do one impression. I do Chris Sarandon as he appeared in Dog Day Afternoon. I'd like to do it for you now, if you don't mind.
I'm dying here!
We should do more impressions, you know, like you know, Larry Storch coming on. Something. If I just keep trying, I know I'm going to hit on something that works. Back to death. When I die, I've decided I'm going to die like my father died. Because my father died totally at peace and in his sleep. And that's how I'm going to die. I don't want to be, you know, like screaming and clawing at the windows like the passengers in his bus were. Thank you. situation. You got it, you can go. Situation. I think I'm not your chip, I'm the young drummer. It's your. What's the thing I'm gonna let up? It's in a chapel.
In a chapel. In a chapel.
Find a person out here that's in a chapel.
In a chapel. In a chapel.
The greatest person in the world is in a chapel. She can't miss the door, just go for the soul. The greatest person in the world is in a shackle. When I die, I want it show. There's not much to show. Hey, love, in a shackle. Yeah! In a shackle. Medicine man specialty number on his show. He announced to Beatrice and myself that him and the chief were going out to play some, quote, serious bridge, unquote. Needless to say, I never saw my father again. He was shot at Columbia Bridge. I was crestfallen. What my mother was laughing about, I have no idea. I was bummed beyond belief. I had lost my role model. The next period of my life would be a search for a new role model. And my mother would read all the trades, backstage, variety, looking for a gig. Finally, one day she found this cute little ad in the back of backstage stating that Tallulah Bankhead, that's right, Tallulah Bankhead, the star of stage, screen, and the illegitimate theater, was looking for an 8-week camp. My mother and I got on the next banana boat up here to New York. We checked into Tallulah's posh Park Avenue basement, hence my accent. And life at Tallulah's was an idol. She would dress me up like a little Lord Fauntleroy, kind of like Stinky on the Abbott Costello show. The hat with the ribbons, the short pants, the ruffles, the big lollipop. She'd say, "Little Buster, go out to Bethesda Fountain and mingle with your peers." And I'd skip out there with the lollipop and I'd say, "Tiddlywinks, anyone?" And the kids in their park would look at me like I was a bum. didn't take me long to realize that those kids in that park were on drugs. Yes, and not only that, they wanted me to be on those same drugs with them. And the peer pressure was enormous. They didn't have Just Say No yet. I was at the turning point. I was walking down 58th Street, feeling dejected. I passed by a woman's bar. Because they serve children too. And I saw Tallulah in there, and she was talking to a very attractive blonde. Red lipstick, fingernails. She said, "What's your name, little girl?" She said, "Marilyn." She said, "Marilyn? That's a guy's name." She was tough. She was tough. I went up to her. She said, "What's the matter, little Buster?" I said, "To move the kids in the park, they're all on drugs. 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 She said, "Come and sit on my lap, little Buster." And I sat on her lap, but she smelled like mothballs in the gym. You know, it's funny. Every time I smell mothballs in the gym at the same time now, it's like Proust with the Marilyn. Straight down memory lane. This is very hard. Just make it look easy. Anyway, Tallulah gave me these words of wisdom that I never forgot. She said to me, "I don't need LSD, little Buster. I can jump out of the window all by myself." I just want to thank her because she passed away soon after, and I never got a chance to thank her. I just want to say, Tallulah, wherever you are, I know it's probably heaven. There's a chance she slipped in there. I just want to thank you because you were like a father to me. You know, Mr. the Baby?
It's Yavis.
Mr. Baby Yavis. See? That's Keys. That's Keys. What did you know? What are the eggs on? You know. When I get, you know, into this, like, story, you know, about, like, when I was a kid, like, this stuff really gets me. The Latin word of thinking of is focalunge. And I feel like I'm on the verge of some sort of a catharsis here, and I was wondering, like, remember when we were coming over here, maybe by limo?
See?
If we were to do that song now, I have a feeling that I could have a breakthrough, and I think my shrink would be pleased at that, because right now he's outfitting his boat. It's the one he bought with my money, and he's got a few of 17, so that's the fortune, my money.
Es espantosamente, este momento, cantar esta canción rápidamente. Ahora.
Thank you.
fabulous gift it makes around this time of year. If you go into the record store, you'll find there's plenty of them. But what else is new? You know? Perhaps I'm a bit marginal, I don't know. Our next record, Klezmer Western Swing. longer staying are welcome. You want us to keep doing what we're doing? Or... It's me. I get this vibe, like, oh God, you know. I'm boring them to death. Maybe I'm not. Maybe it's just me. I know a lot of great jokes, but I can't tell them here because you think I'm not PC now. I try so hard to be PC. I just can't get it. I can't get it. I try. A plane for you now that is so PC. Oh, it's beautiful. It's linda. It's what I was thinking. with the frail on so much up here. It certainly has crossed my mind. The reason is that, what's today? Saturday. Tomorrow morning, we go out to MacArthur Field and we get on a Carnival Airlines and we shoot down to the beautiful town of Ponce, Puerto Rico. And we check into a cute little joint, goes by the name of Gonzalez's Dryout Clinic. Gonzalez! His name used to be Duffy, he changed it. He's an ex-homicide detective from Queens. He took all his retirement money and he opened up a cute little dryout clinic in Ponce. He can get your liver in like 5 days. He just like wrings it out. And you come back to New York and you are ready for the fall party season. Oh. A typical day at Duffy's, we get up 11:30, 12. The breakfast buffet has been decimated, but there's lots of coffee and we drink it. And we smoke. And we kibitz about the other schmucks that are down there drying out. And you would recognize a lot of them. Especially if you watch Channel 47. But they have sports stars. They have TV weather people. Clowns. Various high-ranking members of the clergy. I can't tell you their names because we take the Duffy's Pledge. But take it from me. Luncheon is served promptly at 2, I believe. And it's a buffet affair. And, they have a dish on that smorgasbord that I can actually stomach that it goes by the name of
sea legs.
How do you say sea legs going on in Spanish? Yeah. You can tell you don't eat them. Because you know what? Generally they go down, they stay down. And you wash it down with a few old rolls, and it's touching off for a minute, and they're like, Especially the first couple of days, it's rough. After lunch, some of the kids in the band like to go out on the beach and toss around the old medicine ball, but not me. I like to go back to my room, draw the blinds, pop a few Valium, watch all my children, and smoke. After which I take a nap. After the nap, we get all cleaned up and shaved and everything, like we're going on a hike. And we come down to Duffy's beautiful Roomba room. We drink these faux zombies. Faux, it doesn't matter how many you drink, they don't do anything. It's placebo. But if you're used to having something in your hand, you know, it's good. Shirley Temple zombie. Son of the zombie. They had a Japanese Roomba band when we were down there drying out last year. Oh man. Female Japanese Roomba band. They had a bongo player in that band. I nicknamed a satellite. Want to know why? Because I thought a keister was out of this world. I'm like getting like Stewie Stone. I feel like Corbin Monica in a Twilight Zone episode. We were down there watching this rumba band, and I was in awe. I mean, I just thought it was fantastic. You know, who should come up to me while I'm watching you? Maury A. Maury A. Maury A. Sorry. Maury A. Strike that in the record. Maury A. All right? So, Maury says to me, oh, brush fire. I said, hey, Maury, it's going to be a great night, huh, if it doesn't rain. So, you know, Maury is the guy who turned the Andrews sisters on to Roman Coca-Cola, literally and figuratively. I believe he turned Rosie Clooney on to Seminole, but I'm not sure.
Is that
from
the fifth?
Anyway, here's a man who, like, knows his stuff, let's face it. They had a big hit. And he told them to sing it, and he was telling me to sing this song. So we took it back to the States, and we'd like to do it for you now, because I'm dying here. I just wanted to say we're doing this song because I think that you are probably the greatest, and I mean it's the greatest audience whatever you gave. In all my history, my career, and I'd like to tell you exactly how strong my feelings are for you, but of course, being a man, I can't express them. But I think my beautiful Booster Yeahs being of the summable persuasion could probably tell you how I feel.
I'm on the ground, feeling hot.
personal friend of mine. Buster Claw and Dexter.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for coming down. We hope you had some fun. We did, so we're going to sing our theme song. Good night, folks. Brian, hit the note.
Who's the leader of the band that's playing for you and me? B-U-S-T-E-R.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you make your way towards the exits.